Dwij is a Sanskrit word which means born twice. But I do not know what do they call a person who's born thrice. So I'm going to take you to my journey of the second and the third birth. The first being, of course, my natural birth. I came to Bombay in 2007, broken, devastated, because I had undergone divorce. And it's a stigma in our society to take a stand according to your own wishes. I was judged. I was in complete turmoil because I did not have the confidence to stand for myself. I did not have the confidence to pursue anything in life. But you know, a little voice inside me said, let's just give it a chance. It's so dark, I can't see anything. But let's see where I go. Let's start making efforts. But the biggest problem or the challenge that laid ahead of me was to find my life purpose. Why do I do whatever I do? Why do I earn money? Why am I walking on this earth? The dream that I had earlier of having a family was shattered. So I was completely rethinking about my life. That's when I connected with the women in 1984 who had suffered the massacre after the death of Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. Lot of Sikhs were killed in India and a lot of them were attacked because of their identity. I connected with my identity because I belong to the 1.4% of the Indian population who are Sikhs. So before I go any further, I'll play you through the promo. Justice can be done in many ways. In South Africa, when apartheid happened, after that, there was a Truth and Reconciliation Commission. Victims came to the commission and it was recorded the kind of human rights abuse that happened with the blacks. There was Rwanda genocide, there was a genocide in Armenia. But there has always been a documentation and the way we look back at the history. But in our country, one of the biggest democracies in the world, one of the youngest nations in the world, and we call it as anti-Sikh rights. There is no such thing as anti-XYZ rights. There is a massacre, there's a genocide. And it's high time that we think about it, or how we are looking at the history. Are we really learning from our history? Because if we don't, it will keep repeating itself. Had there been justice in 84, there would have not been the Bombay riots that happened in 1992. The Gothra riots that happened in 2002 with the Muslims would have not been there. So it's like a cycle that keeps repeating, because we are not learning from what we have endured. We also need to think that, are we really bothered? Are we really bothered about people who are different from us? They may have a different religion, a different caste, a different identity, skin color, the way they dress up may be different. But are we tolerant about them as a young nation? That is the question to ask. So the justice that comes is also with the fact that each one of us, with our thoughts, with our actions, with our conduct, is able to give justice to one and all. Only then justice is possible. And that will lead us to the future with high integrity. So what I did was, an obstacle that came my way, I tried to find my life purpose. I connected with my life purpose. And then I had an expression. So mostly my expression has been films, whether documentary or feature films. Expression can be anything. It can be art, it can be cooking, it can be gardening, it can be crafts, it can be music, it can be anything that you choose. I'll tell you another story. This story is of incredible man called Shaitan Singh Bishnoi, who was walking on this earth with us few years back. In the middle of the night, he heard the cries of a chinkara and he went in the forest to save the chinkara. Chinkara is an Indian gazelle which looks very much like a deer. It's a very beautiful animal, but it is endangered and Bishnois are supposed to protect it. But here, Shaitan Singh, the real hero, goes into the forest unaffected by what is happening outside, and he tries to save the chinkara, but he's shot dead by the hunters. He is survived by his young wife Pushpa Bishnoi and two children, and of course his family. I was privileged to have the honor to make a film on them, how they are caring for the chinkara. Pushpa, after the death of her husband, adopted the chinkara and is raising him like her own son. Bishnois live in tune with nature. Shaitan Singh Bishnoi was a true legend. I'll tell you why. First time when the film was being screened in a film festival in Mumbai, I called up in the village and I said, tomorrow we are going to screen the film on Shaitan Singh. They told me, are you sure, ma'am? Is it tomorrow? I said, yes, it's tomorrow, for the first time in 2 years that we are going to screen the film that we made on it with so many efforts. They said, tomorrow is the death anniversary of Shaitan Singh Bishnoi. Think about a man who lived in tune with nature. Think about a man who cared for the forest, for the trees, for the animals, more than his own children. For me, he's not dead, he's alive. And his legacy is definitely alive, because there are so many communities in India, all over the earth, who are living in tune with nature. But do we really care about nature? What does nature comprise of? Nature comprises of 5 elements: earth, fire, water, sky, air. And according to my belief, it's a personal belief, but I sincerely feel that trees are the 6th element, because trees give us oxygen, they give us life. But are we really bothered? because we are cutting the trees and making highways. The question is, you think about it, what are you leaving behind? Apartments, gold, jewelry, cars, or forests, trees, plants for your children to see, to breathe, to live peacefully and happily. How many plants and trees and animals have become extinct? When I was a child, I remember eating karonda, I remember eating berries, and now those berries and karondas have become so rare to see, and they become like almost like very much difficult to find, to buy, and it's like an exotic fruit now. But thankfully it is still there somewhere. I don't know what is going to happen in the next 50 years. Will these plants, animals, birds, fruits still going to be alive or not? So, coming back to my third birth, there's another story which I want to share with you. Because truth and justice is believed mostly by people who are young. So I was screening the film in schools and colleges in other parts of the country, Kolkata, Mumbai, Delhi, Thiruvananthapuram, where people embraced the film with a lot of love and emotions. A bunch of students connected with me from UK because they wanted to screen the film in the universities there. I had a mission in hand, a spiritual mission. I prayed to the 75 trillion cells in my body to be in alignment with my spiritual mission, to let me allow me to go and screen the film and not any kind of health, sickness or problems come up, show up. Because at that time, I was completely out of tune of my body. I was not taking care of myself. I was eating at whatever time, whatever way I could. And I was leading a very, very hectic lifestyle. I was getting throat infection. I was getting cold. I knew my immunity is low and I need to do something about it. But what do I need to do? I was not aware about that. But anyhow, I was there in UK on this amazing yogic journey where the students had called me. We hardly had any resources. All that we were doing was screening the film. Once the film was publicly screened, it was embraced by a lot of people, and unknown people opened their houses for me to stay, to flourish, to screen the film further. I'm very glad to tell you this, that the film had 40 screenings in UK itself, out of which 20 were there in the university and the remaining 20 were in public forums. And this was the first time I was going to UK and I was not supported by any political foundation. I was supported only and only by people who embraced, who had witnessed 84. I had never witnessed 84. I could only carry forward the stories and pathos by my mother, who had told me what she has seen, what my uncle had seen and endured in 84. So the universe had said, so be it in between. Because after my journey in UK for 2.5 months, I detected a breast, I detected a tumor in my breast. I could never imagine that this could be cancerous because I thought this must be a cyst because I had cysts in my body before, which were benign cysts. Anyhow, my journey had UK had come to an end. I gracefully came to Bombay and I was very, very afraid of what is going to be my future, health-wise and otherwise, because I had spoken my mind in so many places. And I went for the biopsy and the report came on exactly this day a year back. And it was confirmed that I had breast cancer. Again, I was very afraid. There was complete darkness. There was nothing that I could look into. There was no certainty. And I think I was just thinking about these births and I realized that when the child is about to be born, he or she is restless. He or she is getting under the transition, completely in darkness and coming to light. So I think I was also undergoing the same thing, because my friends, my family incredibly supported me, loved me, and let me live and flourish. And that is the reason that I am there with you today. Very, very grateful to be alive. But then, when I was undergoing all this chemotherapy and radiation and everything, I realized there are so many stigmas around breast cancer. There are so many myths around breast cancer. Do we need to do something about it? And the only thing that I know now is to make films. So you've guessed it right. I'm making a film on it. And I've written a feature film script, and I'm also making a documentary on my experiences with breast cancer and trying to demystify what causes cancer. Because of course it's a very, very complex subject. And I wish I had seen or any kind of a documentary that would have led me to give some kind of hope at that time when I was struggling with my disease at that time and undergoing a very powerful emotional experience. So, very, very glad to be here with you. But then I'll just sum up what I wanted to say. So whenever there are obstacles, there are two ways that you can deal with it. You can either complain about it and shift the blame to everyone around you or to yourself. There is another response that you can choose to consider, and that response is to look within, to see what needs to shift within, or is there anything outside in the world that needs to shift? To understand what that response can do for you, to take the charge of that response, to take that action of that particular response, because that response will take you to another path, and that path can lead you to your expression, which can be anything. Thank you very much for listening to me.